It's finally here. Jeez, I felt like I waited forever for this one. Captain Toad, Pokken Tournament, Donkey Kong Country, Tropical Freeze, heck, even Tokyo Mirage Sessions, but not 3D World? Honestly, at one point, I almost gave up hope. It seemed so odd to me. Why wait? We all saw how well New Super Mario Bros. U Deluxe did, so what was the holdup? Possible delays, or maybe even took a bit longer to develop than a traditional port? Who knows, I'm just very happy it's here. Super Mario 3D World is my favorite title on the Wii U, hands down. I love the Wii U in every port we have gotten. I've bought them with zero complaints. I'm just happy these great games are more accessible. The wait is over, and now I can take a proper look at New Super Mario 3D World plus Bowser's Fury. So as I mentioned earlier, initially 3D World released on the Wii U. Well, nobody bought a Wii U. As odd as it sounds, 3D World is practically a brand new Mario title for most people. So what exactly is 3D World? Super Mario 3D World was the follow-up to the Nintendo 3DS title Super Mario 3D Land, which released all the way back in 2011. Both games take elements from a traditional 2D Mario title and a traditional 3D Mario title and blend them together to create a 3D environment with linear level design and limited mobility in terms of what you're used to in most sandbox Mario titles. Now we know the basis behind 3D World, so let's dig into the plot. Don't blink because you might miss it. Bowser kidnaps the Sprixy princesses, sends his minions to assert control over Sprixy Kingdom, and it's up to our four brave heroes to stop him. Yes, I said four, and yes, I said Princess Peach wasn't kidnapped. 3D World allows you to play as Luigi, Mario, Toad, and Princess Peach, just like in the NES title Super Mario Bros. 2. Peach is floaty, Mario is the most well-rounded, and who I tend to play as the most, Luigi is slippery but jumps high, and Toad is the fastest out of the Bravely bunch. You can choose any of the four before entering a stage, which is super simple. If you're like myself and tend to stick with one character, you can complete the game with no issue, but some stages require a specific character to acquire collectibles. So even though you only end up playing as Luigi, maybe one stage forces you to use Toad and you end up enjoying how Toad controls. And even if you don't, it's only a handful of stages that require certain characters for collectibles. So it's not much of a hindrance. At this point, you're probably wondering how the controls feel. And let me say, they are great. Tight, smooth, and full of precision. I've never played a platformer with such smooth controls. I always feel like I'm always in full control, and any mistake I make is because of my ability and not how my character controls. Along with insanely fluid controls, 3D World has some fantastic level design with unique gimmicks in certain stages, like getting to the flagpole in under 100 seconds, or trial stages where you have to continuously chase after green stars. Even the standard stages are jam-packed with charming and fun designs. Not terribly difficult by any means, but still fun. I'd highly recommend going for 100% in 3D World because I really feel like you enjoy the game so much more when you do so, and it adds a welcome layer of challenge if you do decide to attempt 100%. You need 3 green stars in most stages and stamps that are scattered throughout. And try to make it to the top of the flagpole in each stage if you can. If you find yourself in a difficult spot trying to grab a stamp or a green star, don't worry. I found that most of the time you can avoid situations like these by exiting the stage, grab a different power-up. Catsup helped me the most, and it's as easy as that. Now, most stages will give you a power-up in the beginning of the stage, and that power-up is essentially the power-up that the stage wants you to use to complete it, but I found that if you try out other power-ups, they allow you to complete these stages a little easier if you're having some issues. For instance, there's some stages in the later half of the game where they use the boomerang power-up, but I found that if you come back with the Cap Mario suit, you can climb up certain walls to nab green stars that might be a little tricky for you with the boomerang power-up. Speaking of power-ups, 3D World has got you covered. We've got the Fire Flower, the Cap Out, which is new to 3D World. This power-up turns Mario into, well, Cap Mario. And the best thing about this is the climbing aspect. Those series veterans will be happy to hear that the Tanuki Suit, Boomerang Mario, and Mega Mario power-ups all make a return. If you find yourself with no power-ups, look on the map screen for a Toad House for some goodies, and they'll have you covered. You will also see Captain Toad's Adventures on the map screen as well, which I won't talk about too much because I do plan on giving Captain Toad Treasure Tracker its own dedicated video, but I will say the stages are a fun distraction, and you will also see mystery houses that I talked about earlier as trial stages, And these are really fun, but can be a bit annoying when you screw up on the last star and have to go through every single star again. It's a bit tedious, but it's honestly not that difficult, but does feel like a bit of wasted time. Boss battles and enemy battles appear on the map screen as well, and honestly, I don't have much to say about these. They're not too fun or terribly difficult. If anything, they're kind of repetitive because you literally face the same enemy or the same boss, and they're pretty easy, but they are easy green stars. Green stars? Oh, they're the main collectible in 3D World. In fact, you actually need them to advance the game forward, but don't worry. Most are pretty easy to find, and I'd be surprised if you don't have enough to progress in the game. I'd say the stamps provide more of a challenge, and even then, they weren't too hard tracking down. So, one thing we haven't talked about yet is Mario's level of mobility. 3D World blends the 2D and 3D Mario titles into one. So how does Mario's level of mobility hold up? Well, it's good. Could be better in my opinion, but it's good. Newly added in the Switch version, Mario can now perform a mid-air dive like in Odyssey. Mario can ground pound jump, somersault, backwards jump, but no triple jump. And that's okay. While all these movement options are great, they feel a bit toned down due to the linearity of each level, which sucks, but I suppose it makes sense given the stage structure. The soundtrack is just as soothing as I remember, truly charming, and kept me smiling from start to finish. I promise, you'll find yourself humming a stage theme during your playthrough. Once you finish your campaign and have collected enough stars, you will be able to access World Star. And this is where the challenge really begins. These are by far some of the best stages in the game, and I highly recommend playing these. You might also have some secrets and possibly a familiar face waiting for you. Well, that just about covers 3D World. Man, what a game. I'm so happy it's finally landed on Switch, and so many people will get to play it for the first time. But wait, there's more. Oh yeah. We aren't finished yet. That's right, once you finish the joy that is 3D World, you've got Bowser's Fury right around the corner. Bowser's Fury is a sandbox 3D Mario adventure, same controls as 3D World, but in a more open world environment. I'm not going to go into any story details for spoiler's sake, so I will primarily be talking about gameplay. First things first, for returning players, you can jump straight into Bowser's Fury. And for new players, I'd recommend playing 3D World first, but of course, the choice is yours. The objective in Bowser's Fury is to collect cat shines, spread throughout Lake Lapcat. In doing so, you will defeat, well, you know who, and restore peace to Lake Lapcat. Bowser's Fury feels like a clever mix of Odyssey and 3D World, but also something new and fresh. No more bouncing from world to world. Lake Lapcat is all one open world area that gradually opens up as you collect more cat shines. It's extremely refreshing to experience something like this in a 3D Mario title, and it's chock full of all the great level design and power-ups from 3D World. You can even stockpile power-ups and hold up to 5 of each, which is incredibly useful. However, one thing in Bowser's Fury I found quite odd, and well, that's Bowser himself. You see, Bowser will pop up from time to time, and you have 3 options. Take him down, wait it out, or lose a life. And things go back to normal. You don't know when Bowser will come back, but you can guess from how far out of the water he is. And if you see it raining, prepare yourself. And unfortunately, you need Bowser at some points to break blocks and other objects you couldn't. And I don't know how I feel about this. I just think it shouldn't be forced onto the player and halt progression in some aspects. Personally, I would have preferred something more traditional, but it was a unique diversion from the norm. Super Mario 3D World plus Bowser's Fury is easily a must-own title for any Switch user. It's what you have come to know and love from Mario's sprawling adventures, with a new spin on things and a completely new adventure for our Italian plumber. Well, I'm going to go play some more Bowser's Fury, and I've got some cat shines I need to collect. I'm hoping you will do the same. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.